Hello everybody, this is Juan-Carlos Holgado from the World Archery Excellence Center and here back in the Coach Me series, and it's a pleasure to be back. Longines. This is Leigh Hadfield. Coach, please find my touch in YouTube video, Coach Mysterious. Excellent, so let's go to see the video. Okay, Leigh, it's obvious you have studied a lot of archery and you have learned a lot about the shooting sequence. So it's nice to see you shooting very good style. Congratulations, good work. I can see there's a lot of work behind by seeing how you practice. I would say that I like your alignment. You have a very good alignment of your elbow, shoulders with the string. It's excellent alignment. I also like your expansion. You have a good expansion on both sides. It's clear you know how to pull, push, or however you interpret the expansion is happening really good. And I like your bow hands and bow arm, really solid, really strong. So these are your three strength points in my point of view. But I guess you are more interested what you could improve. And as I understand archery and I see your shooting, the first one I would say, you are a strong man, you use too much strength to make the shot. You activate too many muscles to shoot. You really don't need so much. You put the hand strong, the face from the beginning, you pull really strong, you try to be very good online, you get too much effort, which at the end, when you want to expand and release, is like an explosion. It's difficult to keep control in the moment that the arrow leaves the bow. So I would recommend you first start relaxing your face when you start and not starting crap. Relax your body and try to reach the same position without so much effort. You have strength enough to reach it. You don't need all the muscle. You just need the muscle that are needed to reach this position. So relax your body physically. Second thing I would say, when you draw the bow, your head is moving a lot. I like, in my way to understand archery, that the head is stable from the beginning, calm, and you adapt the rest to the head. All what is moving the head means that it's difficult to make it consistent. Doesn't mean it's wrong. It's just hard to make it consistent. If we fix the head from the beginning and you find your position and you expand without moving the head, there are much more probabilities to have the same position. Because at the end, the accuracy comes from the distance, from the knocking point to the eyes, and keep this consistent. When we start moving the head, we start moving the knocking point to the eyes, the distance, and then the arrow aim in different ways. So even if you are aiming on the 10, if the knock is moving in different position, you are aiming the arrow in different ways. So how we do that? My recommendation is you find your position and you draw down, and then you keep the head. So you come up, and you find that you don't need to move it anymore. So there's a moment that you will find the muscle memory to reach the right position that you will have at the end of your full draw, okay? It's just repetition, do it a few times and will happen. The goal of it is that you reach the full draw without moving your head, okay? And that's ending the second part of what I would recommend you to change. Your drawing is a little bit to the down, which is fine, but to the outside. So you are bringing it a bit out. Bring it inside you, keep it in you, not out, because this will end in lateral release and not in direction release to the center. And that's into the third point. You are expanding really good, but without moving to the 10. Your goal is to pass a clicker. The goal is not to pass a clicker, it's to direct the arrow to the 10. So clicker is just the moment that we release, but focus more in the expansion where you want to go. If I want to go to a 10, I make my movement to go to a 10. It's not about taking the clicker and releasing, it's about going to the 10. So all the body move direction to the 10. Okay, these three things, which seeing your quality of training and your commitment in the sport, I'm sure you will reach it very fast, okay? To make a fast resume, try to keep the head position stable, find out what's the right one when you enter the full draw, try to make the drawing inside you and not take it a little bit out. And third one, expansion, go to the target, move toward the target, which the three things together, I'm sure we will group a bit better. Thank you very much and keep the work.